What's your favorite part of Christmas?
Dressing up the Christmas tree.
When we get to have all the food.
Getting Christmas presents.
Getting out of my room, peeking the corner, and seeing where Santa Claus is.
What's your least favorite part?
Last year, the tree was fake and we could see right through it.
My brother cries because he's scared of Santa, but I'm not.
What kinds of things do you like to do in the snow?
Play in the snow.
I like to make snowmen, make snow angels,
slide down hills,
snowball fights.
And then I like to skate, but really hard. I can't even do it.
Whose birthday is on Christmas?
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus is.
Santa's. I mean, Jesus.
And where was Jesus born?
In a tent.
In a stable.
At a hospital.
In Bethlehem.
In Oklahoma.
What kind of animals were there?
Sheep and cows, horses,
chickens, camels, pigs, elephants,
bunnies and giraffes, zebras,
dogs and kitties.
Why do other people get presents on Jesus' birthday?
Because they've been good.
Well, they gave presents to him when he was born, and we give gifts to each other.
Because Jesus was the gift from God.
What do you think is Jesus' favorite part of Christmas?
Just seeing people happy.
See how everyone's being kind to one another.
Probably the missions for all the homeless people.
If you could give Jesus a present, what would you give him?
A puppy dog.
A snowball.
A little bear, and he loves it.
I'll give him one of my toys.
My love.
My heart.
Everything I had.
Why do you think Jesus came to live with us?
Because he loves everybody the most.
Because he wanted us to be good and not bad.
He's God's son, and that was what God wanted him to do.
And that way he could fix out all the problems that were happening.
He felt like we were more important than him. I think he loves us very much.
Why is Christmas so special?
Jesus was born on that day.
Because you share it with your friends and family.
It's a day where we can spend time and we get to give presents to other people. It's about sharing. We get to praise Jesus.
I love it.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Hi.
Church on Fire, would you stand to your feet this morning? We're going to worship Jesus a little bit more. You guys ready to sing? You guys ready? Come on, do your dance. Clap your hands. Would you clap your hands with us today?
Jesus Christ is born. Oh, he's thousand generations falling down in worship to sing the song of ages to the Lamb. And all who've gone before us and all who will believe will sing the song of ages to the Lamb.
Sing your name.
And your name is the highest. Your name is the greatest. Your name stands above them all. All thrones and dominions, all powers and positions. Your name stands above them all. And the angels cry, holy, all creation. Song forever to the Lamb.
Oh,
and we'll sing a song forever and amen. And the angels cry, holy, all creation cries, holy, you are lifted high, holy. Above them all,
your name.
Your name.
Declaration. Before we pray, just want to welcome any guests here today. We're so glad you're here, aren't we, church? For all of our guests, come on, put your hands together. So glad you're here. Thanks for coming out and being a part and being with us. Hope this isn't your last time. Love to see you again. So let's pray. Lord, thank you for your blessings to us. Thank you, Jesus, that as we celebrate Christmas, we know why you came. You came for us, for me, for each one in this room, for the whole world. So as we get into your word today, help us to do what your word says in James 1:21. We receive with meekness your engrafted word. Psalm 119:11, we hide your word in our heart that we might not sin against you. Psalm 119:105, we will make your word a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. James 1:22, we're going to leave here today. After we hear your word, we're going to do what it says in Jesus' name. Everybody say, all right, stay standing. We do a declaration each week. We're going to make this declaration, all right? You ready? I want you to say it like the people on your row can't hear you. On the count of three, here we go. One, two, three. We believe in God the Father and in Jesus Christ, His only Son. We believe in the Holy Spirit. We believe that Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection brings us life and the forgiveness of sins. We believe in the biblical outlines of marriage and gender. We believe in the sanctity of all life, regardless of race or nationality, beginning at the moment of conception and ending at death. We will do anything short of sin to see people come to the saving knowledge of Christ. Why? Because we love people. All right, hey. Hey, give a bow. Give about five people a high five, and let's have a seat. Awesome. Awesome. Let me say this real quickly. If you are an elementary age child, you are free if you want to go. You don't have to. Go through that door right there, and there's a room there. They have some special things for kids in elementary. Feel free to go. You don't have to, but you are welcome to go. We'd love for you to join. Hey, didn't our children's ministry do a great job with our kids? Woo! They did awesome. Awesome. Okay, before we get into the Word, I want to play a video that our staff did. We did it just for you. It's a funny video. Let's play it. Are you ready, guys?
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
You have such a pretty face. You should be on a Christmas card.
Buzz, your girlfriend. Woof.
What? I can wrap anything, sir, with 3 bits of sticky tape. 3.
I specifically bought enough food to last until January.
How much emotional eating have I been doing?
Humbug.
The blessing.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
Merry Christmas, little fella. We know that you're in there and that you're all alone.
The best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
Just because I cannot see it doesn't mean I can't believe it.
Everyone, this is Mary and Joseph. And that's their new baby.
The flock is growing.
And to the republic for which it stands.
This isn't a joke. This is military. This is SEAL stuff. I saw it on Discovery Channel.
Faith is believing in things when common sense tells you not to.
Yes, this Christmas music. It's joyful and triumphant.
Bliss is highly nutritious, microwavable macaroni and cheese dinner that people sold in on sale. Amen.
Oh. Ah. Mmm. That's it, I'm not going.
One nation, indivisible.
Oh, come on, Mom.
Right now!
Immediately, my feet began to sweat as those two fluffy little bunnies with the blue button eyes stared sappily up at me.
Sisters, sisters, there were never such devoted sisters.
What a lovely family heirloom.
You're tacky and I hate you.
Tess, that's not a Christmas movie.
Well, it's true.
Liberty and justice for all.
And a happy new year.
That's just for you. Just for you. And our team did a good job. Wasn't that awesome? Funny. All right. Okay. When you drive around, I see manger scenes. And at Christmas, we think baby Jesus. And that's what we should think, right? We're remembering him coming to the earth. But everything the world needs, everything the world has needed, everything the world will need is inside of that baby. Now he grew up, we talked to last week, like he knew exactly who he was. He knew when he was 12, he knew in his 30s, exactly who he was and why he came. So I want to tell you who he was in John 1, 1 through 4. I want us to look together. You can look on the screen. If you have your Bible, you can look there. But I emphasize a word there, which is the word word. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. All right, stay there. Let's do it again. It's important. We know who the Word is. That's Jesus. So we know he's the Word. Look at what it's saying. Ready? Let's say the word, Word again. In the beginning was the
Word.
And the
Word.
Was with God. And the
Word.
Was God. He was in the beginning with God. Let's move forward. And all things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. In him who? The Word. In Jesus was life, and the life was the light of men. And verse 5, and the light shines in darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. The darkness could not overtake it. The darkness, listen to me, the darkness cannot stop this light. How many know it doesn't matter how dark the world gets, darkness cannot stop the light of Jesus Christ, right? Let me just say this to you at Christmas and moving forward. We are the light of the world. We are the salt of the earth. Why? Because the Word is living inside of us now, right? Okay, good. All right. So I'll move forward to verse 14 of that same chapter. We're going to skip down and I'm going to read it from the Message. I love it how it says this. Look at this. The became flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood. Isn't that cool? The King James is, and the Word became flesh and dwelled among us, the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. But the Message says, and the Word became flesh and moved and blood and moved into the neighborhood. I'm going to ask you a question. I ask our men's group this on Friday at 7 in the morning. I ask my men's group this. Put it up on the screen. If Jesus were walking the earth right now, where would he do ministry? Price Hill, somebody said, okay, I'm with you. I'll say it again. If Jesus were walking on earth right now, where would he do ministry? And I want to say this to you. He did a lot of ministry in the synagogue. When he went to the synagogue, you know, he healed people and he taught the Word and he forgave people's sins. But the majority of his ministry was outside the four walls of the synagogue. So if Jesus were here today, he would be in Price Hill. He would be over the Rhine. He would be in the streets. He would be at Cracker Barrel. A lot of you are going today as soon as you leave here. He would be there. He would be there, wouldn't he? Why would he be there? He says in Luke 19, he said, I came to seek and save that which was lost. I came to seek and save that which was lost. So if I would title this, which I'm going to, I would say the title of this message is The Ultimate Search and Rescue Mission. The Ultimate Search and Rescue Mission. So he would be on a, listen now, on a search and rescue mission looking for you. He is on a search, and some of us have found him, but those who haven't, he's on a search and rescue mission looking for you, looking for the world, looking for people who don't know him. And I want you to get this. I talked to somebody this week and how they felt that, about the Lord and struggling with their struggles, and God might be mad at me. I want you to understand something. God is not mad at anybody in this room. He loves people. It's not his will that anybody should perish, but that all should come to repentance. He loves you. It doesn't matter how bad you've been. Doesn't matter how far you've gone. He loves you. And I said to this person, you have kids, right? Do you love your kids? Yes. Is there anything they could do that you would reject them and turn away from them? No. I said, are you better than God? Are you better than Jesus? He loves you. He's on a search and rescue mission. Okay. First thing he was doing on the search and rescue mission was he came to bring us healing. Lots of kinds of healing. There's physical healing. Some of us in here this morning need physical healing. Some of us in here this morning need emotional healing. You ever, anybody besides me ever needed healing with your emotions? Anybody besides me ever been afraid? Anybody inside, besides me ever been angry? Anybody in besides me ever been worried? Just me? Okay. He said, I came to heal your emotions. I came to heal your body. I come to heal relationships. I've come on a search, Jesus said, I've come on a search and rescue mission to heal people. Now, I don't know if you've seen Chosen, but this morning I'm going to play two clips from Chosen. And this first one, it just rocks me when I see it. Let's just watch this this clip of Jesus coming to heal somebody. Let's watch it.
This is what all the fuss is about. An oversized mikveh.
I have a feeling we haven't seen it all yet.
That's him.
Who?
Him. The one who's been here the longest. But doesn't belong. The sad one.
Why do I get the feeling this isn't just a meeting? Do we need to be on the lookout?
No. Just stay with me and watch.
Shalom.
Me?
Yes.
Shalom.
I have a question for you.
For me. I don't have many answers, but I'm listening.
Do you want to be healed?
Who are you?
We'll get to that later. But my question remains.
Will you take me to the water? Look, I'm having a really bad day.
You've been having a bad day for a long time. So?
Sir, I have no one to help me into the water when it's stirred up. And when I do get close, the others step down in front of me. And so...
Look at me. Look at me. That's not what I asked. I'm not asking you about who's helping you, or who's not helping, or who's getting in your way. I'm asking about you.
I've tried.
For a long time, I know. And you don't want false hope again, I understand. But this pool, it has nothing for you. It means nothing. And you know it. But you're still here. Why?
I don't know.
Need this pool. You only need me. So, do you want to be healed? So let's go. Get up, pick up your mat, and walk.
Ha ha ha!
I'm free to walk, like he said. Don't forget your bed.
Why does this matter?
Because you're not coming back here. That life is over. Everything changes now.
Isn't that awesome? Everything changes now. Isn't that awesome? So if he walked into this room, did you notice how he looked and he said, see that man right there? That's the guy I'm after. If he walked in this room, you think, well, he'd be for everybody else. No, he'd walk right up to you. He loves you. That's why he came. Second point, he came on purpose just for you on a search and rescue mission. I went to Kansas last week with a buddy of mine, Bruce, and it was an anti-sex trafficking meeting. There was about 35 guys there. One group was called Guardian Group, and they go online and they find women who are being sex trafficked. There are men, but mostly women. And then they send it to authorities and they go in and rescue them. There was another group there that would go in and rescue them. And then there's most men opposing sex trafficking. That meeting had three different armed forces. Well, most of them were Army. Had Green Beret, Delta Force, and Rangers, Green Beret, Delta Force, and Rangers. And I'm eating dinner with these guys. I didn't know who they were. And they started training us on how to go in and rescue people who are being sex trafficked. And they taught us all kinds of things in a whole day. Well, that night they set up a rescue mission for us. So we're in our cars and we know who it's pretend, but it felt real to me. And we're following this car, and we were instructed. We had radios and all that. And we saw this man who we had a picture of, knew that he sex trafficked girls. We saw him go in this building. And so we had these pretend guns, but they really shot. Some of them shot rubber bullets. It was scary, little. It hurt. And we're going in, and we knew he was in there. We knew she was in there. There were three guys and her, and we went in on a search and rescue mission for this girl. And when we went in, I mean, they're shooting at us, and we're shooting, and we're going through. If you got shot, you're out, and like legit. And we went down these stairs, and they're shooting, and we got to this place, and there was a cage, and there was a girl in the cage laying on a mattress, and she was rescued. But they said, guys, see how this feels? This is real. This is real. Girls are really in cages being held and sex trafficked. And our goal is to go in and rescue them. Now, some of the girls and some of the guys that have been involved have now become the rescuers. Listen to me. Some guys and girls have become the rescuers. This is what I want to tell you before I move forward. When I come to Christ, when I come to Christ and he rescues me and saves me from my sin, I become a rescuer. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So I was talking to a guy this week, and I'm not trying to call him out, but he said, you know, I've been just staying in my house and praying, and I've just been praying, waiting for this revival. And I said, bro, stop sitting in your house and waiting. Hit the streets. Hit the streets. Listen to this statement. I can't remember who said it, but I'll quote it. It says, I'm not waiting for a move of God. I am a move of God. I am. So he works through us and we go out. But here's the thing. There are people, they're walking around. You may be in this room or watching online, and your life is just bound up. And Jesus said, I came on the ultimate search and rescue mission just for you. I want to walk up to you and say, be free. I want to walk up to you and say, be free. I've got one more clip. This is one of my favorite clips of all of Chosen, and then we'll finish. This is the woman at the well. Let's watch it.
Give me a drink. Did you hear me?
That's bad, huh?
What?
You, a Jew, ask for a drink from me, a Samaritan, and a woman.
I'm sorry. I should have said please.
You know, it's not safe for you to be alone out here.
Nor you. Why haven't you come with others? Why so late in the day? Don't women come to the wells in the cool of the morning?
Yeah, well, none of them will be seen with me, so I have to come out now, in the heat, as you have so kindly reminded me.
Why won't they be seen with you?
Long story.
I'd still like a drink of water, if you can spare it.
Amazing what a parched throat will do. Aren't I unclean to you? Won't you be defiled by this vessel?
Maybe some of my people say that about your women, but I don't.
Yeah? And what do you say?
I say if you knew who I am, you'd be asking me for a drink.
Really?
And I would give you living water.
Would. Except that you have nothing to draw water with, and this is a deep well. Besides, what do you need from me if you have your own supply of living water?
Long story.
But Jewish water is better than Samaritan water, hmm?
That's not what I
said. Are you a better man than our ancestor Jacob, who dug this well? Your water is better than his?
I know Jacob. And everyone who drinks this water will thirst again. But whoever drinks the water that I give him will never be thirsty again.
Wouldn't that be nice?
The water I give will become in a person a spring of water welling up to eternal life.
Really?
Yes, really.
Prove it.
First, go and call your husband and come back. I will show you both.
I don't have a husband.
You are right. You've had 5 husbands. And the man you're living with now is not your husband.
Oh, I see. You're a prophet. You're here to preach at me.
No.
Usually the one good thing about coming here alone is I can escape being condemned.
I'm not here to condemn you.
I've made mistakes. Too many. But it's men like you who have made it impossible for me to do anything about it.
How?
Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain. But you Jews insist Jerusalem is the only place for true worship.
They say that because the temple is there.
Yeah, exactly where we're not allowed.
I'm here to break those barriers. And the time is coming when neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem will you worship the Father.
So, where am I supposed to go when I need God? I've never received anything from God, but I couldn't thank him even if I did.
Anywhere. God is spirit, and the time is coming and is now here that it won't matter where you worship, but only that you do it in spirit and truth. Heart and mind, that is the kind of worshiper he's looking for. It won't matter where you're from or what you've done. Do you believe what I'm telling you?
Until the Messiah comes and explains everything and sorts this mess out, including me, I don't trust in anyone.
You're wrong when you say that you've never received anything from God. This Messiah you speak of, I am he. The first one was named Ramin. You were a woman of purity who was excited to be married. But he wasn't a good man. He hurt you. And it made you question marriage and even the practice of your faith.
Stop it.
The second was Farzad. On your wedding night, his skin smelled like oranges. And to this day, every time you pass by the oranges in the market, you feel guilty for leaving him. Because he was the only truly godly man you've been with. But you felt unworthy.
Why are you doing this?
I have not revealed myself to the public as the Messiah. You are the first. It would be good if you believed me.
You picked the wrong person.
I came to Samaria just to meet you. Do you think it's an accident that I'm here in the middle of the day?
I am rejected by others.
I know. But not by the Messiah.
And you know these things. Because you are the Christ. I'm going to tell everyone.
I was counting on it.
Spirit and truth.
Spirit and truth.
It won't be all about mountains or temples.
Soon, just the heart.
You promise?
I promise.
This man told me everything I've done. Oh, he must be the Christ!
Hey, wait!
Your water!
You forgot your
Wow. I want you to listen. We're going to sing a song. We haven't sung in a long time. Some of you may know it. Then we're going to go home. But here's what's important. I don't know if we can view Jesus like that, but that's the word. The word of God says that's how he is. He said to that lady at the well, I came here on purpose. Why do you think I'm here at noon? I came here on purpose just for you. Some of you are feeling right now the Lord touch your heart. He knew you'd be here. He knew you would be here. And what he's saying is, listen, I know all the things you've done, but I was born at Christmas and I died on the cross to take away your sins. Every one of them. Every single one of them. And so, if you know this song, we're going to sing it together. If you're in here and you say, Doug, I have to have Jesus in my life. I know he's been on a mission to find me. I want to give my life to him today. So I want you to talk to him while we sing this song. Give your life to him. believe Christmas is about the Messiah coming to seek and save the lost, to be on a search and rescue mission just for you. So if you know this song, sing it. If you're here and you want to give your life to Christ, just do it while we sing, all right? Sing it, Lily, and I'll sing with you.
He is jealous for me.
Come on, sing it, church.
Love's like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by his glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me.
Sing it now.
And oh, how he loves us so. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us so.
Sing that chorus again. And oh,
and oh,
sing it, church.
How he loves us so. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us so.
Let's stand on our feet. We're going to sing it again. I want prayer team to come. Our prayer team, come, please. And while we're singing, if you need prayer this morning, why don't you just walk down and say, will you pray for me? If you don't know Christ, say, lead me to Christ today. I want to find Christ. We're going to sing it one more time. If you need prayer, come down. Then I'm going to dismiss you, all right? He is jealous. Let's sing it out.
And he is jealous for me.
Come on, sing it out.
Love's like a hurricane.
You need prayer. Come on, we want to pray for
you. Bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy.
When all of a sudden,
when all of a sudden,
I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory.
And I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me.
Oh, come on, sing it out.
And oh, how he loves us so. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us so.
Now change it from oh to me. Oh to me.
And oh, how he loves me so. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, how he loves me.
How he loves me so. He loves us. Oh, how he loves us.
Sing it out.
Oh, he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves.
Amen. So as we leave today and we go into this week of Christmas, and just remember why he came. Remember that he came for me and you. And if there was only one person on the earth, and it was you, he would come just for you. He would, just for you. So I'm going to bless you. I'm going to send you home. I just want to remind you, we're doing Christmas Eve this week. At 5 o'clock, that's our only service. We're not having anything Sunday, just Christmas Eve. There will be a lot of people, so just be prepared. We're going to meet at 5 o'clock, all right? It's going to be awesome, and I'm excited about it. So let me bless you. Put your hands out like this. Maybe you knew. I end with a blessing every week because death and life are in the power of the tongue. I'm going to speak life over you right now. So, Lord, over every marriage in this place, no matter what state it's in, I bless it. Those who are struggling, those who maybe are on a path of separation or divorce, bless them. Heal that marriage. And, Lord, for every home, fill it with peace and joy and rest, knowing that no matter what happens in the world, you've got us. You've got us. We're in your hands and you care. And you love us. Bless our homes. Bless our children. Everybody who has children, no matter how old they are, say, Lord, bless my children. Bless them. Let them enjoy a wonderful life. Let them know the path that you have prepared for them. Protect them as they do the things they do. Lord, those that are single and don't have a spouse yet, direct them on the correct path for the spouse that they should have. Be with our children. Lord, be with our people that have lost a loved one. They've lost a spouse or a child or a friend or a relative. Be with them in this difficult season, I pray. Lord, this is tough. Be with them, I pray in Jesus' name. And Lord, as we move through this week, Lord, just bless us and let us know that because we're rescued, we are now the rescuers and that we would bring life to people this week. We pray in Jesus' name. Now look up at me. It's important. The Lord bless you and keep you and make his face shine upon you and lift his countenance upon you and be gracious unto you and give you peace. Say this with me. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Church, Merry Christmas. Have a great, 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 great week. Hey, thank you so much for joining our family Christmas service. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope it brought some joy to your heart. Listen, if you made a decision today to follow Jesus Christ, I want you to do me a favor. Text the word heart to 513-268-0756 because we want to get you on a path to following Jesus Christ. Thank you so much, man. You made the greatest decision of your life. Let me also say, this Saturday night, December 24th, we're going to have our Christmas Eve service. It's at 5 o'clock here at the church. You can also join us online. We'd love to see you here. So this Saturday, December 24th at 5 o'clock, we're doing our Christmas Eve service. There will not be any services here on Sunday, December 25th. So thank you so much. Let me just bless you as we go. Listen, may the Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you, lift his countenance upon you, be gracious unto you, and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let me say to you one time before you go, Merry Christmas.